Hello, one of my first pretty builds. I messed it up and set this, but I'm gonna keep it anyway. So, pretty much, I've been saving up my money this summer to build the parts to build a PC. Now, I haven't gotten all the parts yet, some of them are out of stock or whatever. But I've gotten most of them, so in this part, I'm going to assemble them. And I'll assemble the other two parts in the other video. So, start with, here is the PC case, the Torsair 300R. And as you see, I opened it up already. And, well, if I open it up, I have to remove these thumb screws here, if you can see that. To remove the case, of course. Which I've already done this, I removed all the cable ties and whatnot. And here you go. Sorry about that. So here is the inside of my case. Now, as you see there's a back to it where you can mount your cables through. So there's another two thumb screws to take out. So I'm gonna take that out here. One of the screws fell. Probably should have gotten a magnetic dish for this, but also, by the way, guys, this is my first PC build ever. So yeah, this is the back of the case. So pretty much, the case came with manual and this bag. It has the hard drive screws and some cable ties. And that's pretty much it. Hold on a sec. Tape measure here. I'm gonna bring out my phone to show you guys. Record a video there, switch to that. Wait, huh? I haven't figured this out. I should have gotten someone else to hold it. But that couldn't really work out. Bloopers! But there's about 1 inch of room to work. You guys probably can't see that. But yeah. So the first thing that I will install is I haven't really thought this through of what to install first. I guess I'll start with this thing, and as I probably most likely mentioned in the video, I opened the power supply here, the little flap here. But yeah, I'm just gonna move the case aside for a minute. This is pretty much the heart of the build. Okay, so I'm gonna unbox this again. And here you go, your power supply. I got a 500 watt TR2 power supply, and this has cable management. Mine has all the cable ties where it needs to. And it comes with a standard power charge or whatever. But I open this first because I have a bunch of static. I'm working on a carpet, which, if you've ever known how to build a PC before, is like the worst place to ever build a PC. So, what I'm gonna do is plug the power supply in. Some screws. Don't turn it on, and then whenever I move, I put my hand on it, so then I to get rid of the static in me, because of the ground right here. So that's a little trick if you're working on carpet. And you can also wear like an anti-static bracelet or whatever. Warning, slip, blah, 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 blah. Come on, remove the sticker. Yeah, I'm gonna plug it in pretty much whenever I put my hand on it. It's gonna remove the static. pretty much any large metal object that can be plugged in. There. Okay, so now that that's plugged in or whatever, now I'm going to get out the motherboard. Here we go, it's the, well, I already need the parts. The ASRock 970 Extreme R 2.0. So, we open this up. We have the metal black plate to put on our PC case here. We'll do that in a little bit. Mounting screws or whatever. And quick installation guide. But I hope there's like multiple languages in here, because this isn't quick. And there's also a CD drive. And this is really important, because this is how you connect to the internet. So then you can download your internet driver. Your drivers on the internet. You also get a SATA cable here, I have a couple. And then, what you've all been waiting for, motherboard. Ta-da! Ta-da! So it's in anti-static wrap here. So I'm going to take this out. Hold it, whoa. So, we're going to actually, if you don't have a place that's anti-static, the motherboard box is actually anti-static, so once you take it out of its sleeve, you can work on it. Right here, on the motherboard. So, I'd probably cut that out, but out for you. But here, as you see, oh yeah, my different focus. Okay, so you have four USB 2.0, two USB 3.0, and these SATA port. Then there's your standard stuff like HDMI or whatever. Is there HDMI? Oh wait, there isn't because it's an because it supports AMD processors. So yeah. Guys, if you don't know, AMD, their processors with integrated graphics are called APUs, but their regular things are called CPUs. So, to actually run this, I need a graphics card, which I'm going to put in. So now, I'm going to put in this thing, the AMD FX8350, so... don't want to tear up the package too much. Oh. I say that as I'm tearing up the package too much. So guys, here is your heat sink and fan to pre-applied thermal compound beast. But pretty much, I don't need this, guys, because I have a better one, the Hyper T4 cooler or whatever. It's going to be a lot better than the stock cooler, so I can overclock better. So, and here, it's this and the AMD FX unlock. It's the CPU, the AMD FX unlock. And, well, I'm moving around. My end on there. Okay, so, I have a little sticker here, which I could put on the front to show that I'm using AMD. And there's a little advanced micro devices. Hey, that's what it's... I forgot about that. Yeah, so... I gotta do this very carefully. Put it on, so... I'm gonna... zoom in on the... zoom in here. Come on. I'm using... $200 camera on a... chunky tripod. Okay, so we're going to open this up. Now, with this, you have to align it with the arrow on the top, on the corner there. With the arrow on the on the CPU socket, so I don't know if you can see this, but I just placed it in. Oh, did I bend these pins? No. I'm an idiot. This is my building new PC. First PC build. I had to lift, that handle there. Sorry again. And then, release your CPU. There, and you shouldn't have to use any pressure, but you should use pressure when you put down this that thing. So, next, well, I don't have the RAM right now. I want to use the RAM graphics card in Windows. That's for next week, so now I have the Hyper T4. Blah, 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 blah. So I'm gonna unbox this over here. So, probably should have brought like a pocket knife with me. I have a pocket knife to open this stuff, whatever. I don't know, where's my screwdriver? Yeah. MacGyver. Watch it on Netflix. Come on. This video is going to be long. There we go. Now. So in here is probably a bunch of mounting brackets, because it works with a bunch of different sockets, like the Intel LG 1150, AMD FM2, pretty much everything. So here you get a giant cooler right there. Whoa. It's like the size of my hand or whatever. I hope this fits in my case. I probably should have got the compact version, like the T2 or whatever it's called. Huge heat sink here. Clear fans. So, oh, there's the thermal stick or whatever, so I'm gonna wait. So I have to find the FM or AM 3 Plus in here. Oh no, I guess it's just one bracket. Bag of stuff. 15 minutes in already. Okay, so here's the bracket that goes in the bottom of the motherboard. Some other brackety deedles. These are for LGA 2011. Focus, yeah. So I don't need that. No, I think this is thermal compound based, I think. I don't know. This is gonna take a while. So where are these pad things You know what, guys? I'm not gonna be overclocking yet, so I think I'm going to leave that in the wraps. That's maybe. And then, for now, guys, part two. Alright, that's a tiny CPU cooler right there that came with the AMD. This is gonna be simpler, but I guess now I'm gonna put the T4 on. I'm just gonna find out how to do it, how to put it on. So hang on.
Hey guys, I'm back here, and as you see, I have my CPU I have my computer case lying on my workbench here. So, pretty much I have my motherboard aside here. And I realized that I just put the RAM in first before I can put in the CPU cooler because it's so big. So I have to wait all week before I do that. So currently I'm going to install the motherboard in, and I'm going to put the fan in first because I figured out how to do it. I read the instruction manual. Yeah, so it's over there. So yeah, with AMD processors, it's very simple, because it's already mounting brackets on the motherboard itself. So I'm gonna go bring it over now. Okay, so I put it this side here. So now I shall first ground myself, take away this fan cable from the side or whatever. It's not gonna work, but by handling the CPU motherboard by the plastic thing, but as much plastic as possible, the fan thing. I know I'm probably not doing this the efficient way, and there may be screaming at your screen right now, but I'm doing it the Ben Woodman way. That's my YouTube channel. If a friend's watching this or whatever, yeah. So yeah, here are the screws that I have to put on the standoffs. So you can't see this, it's kind of off screen, but okay, here's a screwdriver and a screw on that, if you can see. Yeah, so it's pretty much an hour later. I'm kind of tired, it's 11:30 at night. Also, I just went to Micro Center today, and I haven't taken a shower yet. I'll take it tonight, because I feel like it. I don't know, I can probably take a shower in the morning. I'm just... Oh, wait. Did I put that in? No. Did I put that in the wrong one? Put that in sideways because the fan's blocked. I don't know, I have to take out the fan or be MacGyver again. So I'm gonna stick it in the... Why do these thumb screws that other side keep falling down? So, I'm gonna have to remove the fan on the side of the case there too. Oh, I'm an idiot. I have to take off this other screw here from the motherboard, because now I have to take on the motherboard again. Myself now, but
One Direction, why did you do this to me? Why tripod, why did you do this to me?
So before I take out all the CPU fans or whatever, I forgot I have to put on the, what's called the IO shield. So interesting. So here's the IO shield. I'm not really a big fan of the colored things here. I guess I help you. So pop this in the side. I don't really know how to do this. I really have to use pressure to get it on. Going in on this side. Okay, it's in. Hello, I'm back. Sorry about the disruption there, but this is gonna pop the IO shield in over there. So I'm going to have to remove the CPU fan first to get that one screw in. Oh. Never mind, you didn't even have to put a screw in. There's no brass standoff there. I have to put one in. And now, to begin with, I had a hard time getting it out. So, in my bag of screws and stuff for my motherboard, ripped from my case, it had another little brass standoff there. So now the motherboard will not burn the case thing. Huh, where are my pliers? Dang it, Should I? Yeah. Yeah, I found my pliers here to put them in. Again, being MacGyver! I should have used that. Should use a hex wrench for this. So right now I'm just gonna screw it in. So I don't think I have to take off the fan. So now put it on. Screw it on now. I don't think you can see that, but it's moving slightly. Now I've got the tightest I can make it, at least. I'm gonna put that one screw back on. The case fan. And now we can get rolling with putting the motherboard on. Ground myself. Probably should be grounding myself more. I really should not be working on carpet. What's up with that? So how does this work? So or is that thing the guy did when you screw it? And that's supposed to go on with the this part on the motherboard. I don't think you can see that, guys, but okay, that fits. No.
That's going to the IO shield perfectly here. Push it through the IO sheet. Okay, now I got the bottom part done. Oh, come on, I'm putting it correctly. Oh, I see.
I left the screw in.
Pressed in off before. Derp. Why isn't it coming out? This is probably extremely boring for you guys. Oh, my back hurts. You guys can't see this, but ow, I hurt myself. There, so. Oh, I see. The brass standoff. There was what? Oh, there already was a brass standoff there. And I screwed the screw in there, here. And then I put another one on because I thought it was missing, so. Oh, there's a brass standoff connected to the bottom of that. This is all confusing to you guys. They said to hold this down with pliers. Alright. Slipping. Dang it. Yes. Okay, guys. My butt saved. My butt saved, yes. Okay. So this one's all beat up and stuff, so now I don't need that because I already had it added next to it, so. That was a huge problem. It just cost me 4 minutes or whatever.
Minor setback, guys. Okay. So all the standoffs should be an R aligned, so now time to screw it up, and I don't mean to fail and break it, I mean put screws in. Oh, you can see that I never turned the camera back there. Okay. So now for screws. One for this corner. And then we get another one. Put it on the opposite corner, because you should always put screws on opposite corners. And normally, well, it feels like this. Oh, this is slightly misaligned on the top here. Slide out. Is it fully in the heel lock? So now. Yes! So now that's in. Now for another one. I probably should have time coded this. Now I'll have to figure out stuff. So if I time coded it, I would know when stuff happened. I put in the description. Like motherboard installation or whatever. I never really set a standard of what I'm gonna be doing in what order. This video is probably gonna be maybe an hour long. So screws on top of the motherboard here. And bend the RAM slot thing. Put the RAM in. I'll tell about that later. I'm sorry, guys, if I sounded better in the beginning of the video. The very beginning, where everything's scripted in it. Everything's scripted and tell you guys the parts. My usual, always too happy attitude, enthusiasm or whatever. Just really tired. I should have waited until the morning to do this. So this is how the screw is put in. Yeah. And it is that. Tell me, guys. No, but it's fine if you're missing a couple screws in your PC build. I know this because I watched a bunch of PC build videos. And if I'm finishing everything and this doesn't work, I'll be super angry or whatever. Yeah, so. Now, to get something out of the way. Oh, sorry about the camera shake there. Maybe I should do some wiring here for the motherboard, because this is going to take a while, and I might as well just do it now. Well, I'm in the mood. No, I'm not really in the mood, but yeah. So, this is the USB cable thing. Usually, if it's USB 3, it's going to be blue, but my case, but for cable management in mind or whatever. So, yeah. Where does this go? Somewhere.
Oh, and I'll probably have to route, I'll just have to find out where it goes and then I can connect. So it goes here. Huh. I'll have to route it through there, maybe? I don't know. It's gonna, for the USB ports, it's gonna go like that, front USB 3.0. Then I'll have to, for cable management reasons, I'll have to, you know, I probably, for wiring, I should, No, it's just a, oh, that was just a CPU fan, that'll be, maybe, so, just have to route it, go behind here, route it to about here, unless maybe, I could route it through back here. Yeah. So let's go. And if I have to move this, I will. Oh, I'm really sorry guys, I did that, but I routed the USB 3 back there. Now for the case fan here, to move this tie wrap and then find where it goes, channel 3 fan, I think it is. Have to put the tie wrap bag on. Tie that back on. Stuff it. And stuff it up here. Maybe I can use like tape or something. So now, for the audio, so this would go, where does it go? HD audio, it goes here. So the power supply is going to be right here. I'll have to of course go back here and maybe yeah, this will work possibly. Okay, that just barely fits. I heard no review that the HD audio is kind of small there. If you guys can see that, I'm gonna throw him. I don't really have a cameraman working for me. So now, so for the power switch, there's it's focusing. Let me take a while to focus.
Is your mouth? Come on. Yeah, so. So. Pretty much I'm gonna be wiring this thing here, so. So for power LEDs, so these things, there's a plus and a minus. So the plus goes here. And then minus goes here. And for some reason, the case didn't come with a tiny speaker to plug into one of these. So then. I think I should do the bottom ones first. This switch is down here. And down here, sorry, I don't have my light. HDD LED.
Let's figure out a way to route this by behind reset switch.
I really should be a CPU fan. Don't be careful about that. So reset switch down there, and then hard disk drive LED to show you. Also, by the way, guys, it's still optional if you want to. But the power switch itself is not optional, so. So keep that in mind. Like the LEDs and stuff. Like the LED for the HDD. So then, back here, route it down here, power switch goes here, and then, and the LEDs go here, power LED. This is minus. Why did I get into building a PC? Should have just bought that one PC. So USB is plugged in there. USB 3.0, that's a 2.0. Hey. I did it. Sorry, slow zoom. Never trust to be dramatic or whatever. Okay, so I think this is the end of the part one. Peace. Hey guys, one more thing I forgot. I want to install the Blu-ray drive, and it's very easy. It's a tool-free mechanism with the course of the engineer. So pretty much, I have to unsnap this thing to let it, and I have to push a little lever inside, and then I'll let this plastic thing come out. It looks like rushed aluminum, but it's plastic. That's what the front is. It looks like rushed aluminum, but it's plastic, and it's good because you can wash off fingerprints. So damage the motherboard here, but I should have done this before. I think I have to do this with the bottom one. I should have done this before I installed the motherboard. It's not hitting against the motherboard, so it must be something. It's a standard 5.5-inch drive. It works with my other computer. That doesn't sound good. Maybe it'll work with this. I hooked all three. I don't get it, it's not working with right here. Oh, I'm an idiot. I have to slide it in from the front. Yep, that was it. So it's wait, let me just find the manual for a second to find out which one put in where did I put the case manual? I had it here a second ago. These aren't them. Oh, wait. I'll just use the screws that came with the optical drive. Because those are the ones that would work best. Well, they came with it. I'll just use them. They may look out of place. But this isn't a windowed side panel. I may upgrade. Oh. Will this work? I think it will. Lower it a little bit. Zoom in so you can see what I'm doing. Good. And that's one. And this Yeah, this takes special screws. They look like normal hard drive screws from like a Dell Inspiron computer, but they're not. Why is this getting stiff? Entire case is moving. Because I didn't put the heavier components in like the power supply yet or whatever. Or hard drives. So it's hitting against the side there, but it shall do for now. So, in the front, I have to put this thing back on the one I put on top. Took it out on top, so. There we go. So just move the camera. Well, I'll just check out this thing. It's about to be recording now. So yeah, just get the loop out. So there you go, there's the Blu-ray drive that I put inside here. Also wired up all these. And that was what I wanted to show you guys. That's it. If I didn't forget anything else. It's tomorrow, I think, by now. Hello, welcome back to my PC build video. It's actually like more than 2 weeks later. I'm gonna get the rest of the parts for the PC tomorrow. Last week I was busy and blah. So it's like Monday or whatever. So pretty much an update. As you see here, there's some LED lighting strips and a power supply, and it's all wired up. What? How did you do that, Ben? You're asking. I did. Because I'm a genius. Yeah. Well, I did it off camera because, you know, routing wires on the motherboard or whatever, ever the CPU, blah, 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 is all boring and stuff. But I made this video to show you. Okay, so, I made the LED lighting there, so I do have it plugged in now. Oh, let me just. I actually had it, it's four strips, two in the bottom, one here, and then one on the top here. My macaroni duct tape that I used to attach, it's falling off. But, yeah, so, where's the control? The one thing I don't like about it is that the controller's actually attached to the cable. I'm stuck in the wastebasket foot thing. Yeah, so here it is. So, as you see, this wire connects to a strip outlet that I've plugged in. So this, yeah, and it changes colors, but you can choose which color to put on permanently. I just press yeah, blah, blah, blah. It's really difficult to explain, yeah. I'm just gonna keep it like that. So pretty much if you press it and beeps and stuff, it does different things. And I couldn't find a double-sided tape, so I was MacGyver and used this macaroni duct tape, I guess. Put it inside out and then put it on there, whatever. It'll do for now, but. And also, throughout the cables through for the LED strip light things, I had to put it through a PCIe bracket. Even I tried putting it through the water cooling thing, but it just wouldn't go out. It just wouldn't get out. I tried. It's just not coming out. It's just bending a little bit, but then it's not coming out. Sorry if I'm rambling here, but it's actually kind of annoying me right now while I'm showing you this. Also, another thing, the cables are really long to plug it in, so it always gets in my way. So I have to use cable ties to fix that up. So now I'm going to show you the back. This case is a little heavier. Probably should have opted for that Corsair Vention C70 now that I think about it. Because that had two handles on it on the top there, but I thought the military that this worked. What is that? Oh wow. This thing's resilient. Also, yeah, I didn't realize that. I still have zoomed in on the water cooling stuff. Let me just zoom out there. Yeah, so, here's the back. So, it's not a modular power supply, so I just stuffed the bane of my existence, Molex connectors, down there, and for the graphics card, since I don't have it in yet, I just tucked it over here so I can put the back bracket on. So, cable management was pretty easy. Well, it was my first job, so I don't really know, but I think I did a really good job on that, where I routed all the cables in the motherboard and used cable ties. Well, I think I told you
told you this already. There was already cable ties on them. Stuff like these, I didn't put them on. It just came with the power supply instead of sleeves. I don't really know why they did that, but yeah. Also, a tip, if you're going to be giving cable ties to your friend, just giving them to them, you give them, you get a bunch and then you wrap them up in a cable tie. So, even if it gets too loose, you can just pull on it. It'll snap a couple times, yeah. And also, I mounted one of the hard drives to there, so I just put it there. Just one of them I had laying around that I went to put my PC build. And also, there's my desk lamp, which I'm going to be using in a minute. I had this whole thing planned out, or whatever. So, I think that's all for the update. Right now, this is going to be like a day for me, a couple seconds for you, but I'm going to go after I cut, but I'm going to turn it around again. Oh my gosh, this isn't really heavy, just a bunch of stuff on my desk or workbench here. Also, I decided to put the CPU power supply down, and the fan facing down, because I had it facing up, I couldn't reach, the CPU power connector couldn't reach. I know I can get, like, some extenders, but there's, like, there's, a fan filter down there. There's holes for it, so that won't block the airflow, would make serious problems or whatever. And then, I realized something that I'm gonna have to figure out a way to put this in properly, because right now it's gonna go on, it has to go on either facing up or facing down, but I want to go facing up because it's facing the top bracket here for more airflow. But even if I do it both ways, it's still it's gonna be hitting this thing right here, the outtake. So the outtake isn't important, and there's a bunch of the ventilation even without fans in the case. So I'm thinking possibly move this fan on top here, where it'll be over here. Oh, we can't see that. Where there's ventilation on the top here, and you can put stuff on it. So yeah, that's an idea, but I'll figure out something by then, totally. Yeah, so now, what you've all been waiting for. How epic this thing looks when the lights are turned down and I put on the, and I put on. Stay outside, but that shouldn't matter. I turn on this. Why can't life be easy? So it's going to be like that. Go. Oh, it'll work better from a side view. Just one
hey, second. What's up, guys?
It's usually better at night, where you don't see them. There's daylight, even through the curtains or whatever. I need blinds. Blinds here. So, that's what my epic grand thing. It works better at night. Wait, let me just cut it. It'll be the night. Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back, and again, here it is. And here I am. And I found your reference there. But here I am at night. In my hand, I have this desk lamp from Walmart. Yeah, okay, so this is how cool it looks from at night. Cool. So, So now,
let's start recording tomorrow. I'm getting kind of tired. It's only 9 o'clock. I'll see you in another second for you, and about another day for me. Hey guys, I forgot to tell you something. I just kind of tidied up the cable, the really long cables. So what I did was that with cable ties, I just punched up. It's like when it would have been like almost 10 feet of cable. It's really long. So now I'll shorten that. I also have tidied up this. And also, I've gotten this to work where I've gotten the cables through just enough where, well, how I got it through the water cooling things without having to pop out the entire thing was, hey guys, welcome back to PC. It wasn't actually 24 hours since I've recorded this. It's been more like 24 hours and 30 minutes. Game breaker. But first I just need to raise my tripod here to get a better overhead view of everything. With the tripod board, I was kind of doing some. That's my messy setup over there. I had an organized system here on my desk. But then, when I started building my PC, I had to move everything. So because some of the stuff is on my floor here, and some of the stuff is by my old monitor and setup and everything. So, yeah, and also, as you see, I took out a lot of the stuff that was on my desk, and I put them all. Also, right, my room is just a mess right now, so, hi. So, in this video, episode, part thing, I'm gonna install the RAM, and then the cooler. And then, it's late at night, I'm just gonna install the graphics card later, and then Windows, and also, I actually got Windows. Yeah, pro. I'm not gonna show the product key, so I'm gonna take another sleeve and just. There it is. I'm hiding the product key, because, yeah, you know I'm gonna register this before I finish editing the vid. I may have to edit the vid on this rig. I don't know. Has Ecores, it's better than mine. Okay, I'm getting sidetracked, so, also, another reason why I want to get overheat view. I have to adjust this again, but I'm gonna have to put this on its side here. So let me just adjust the camera. You know, I'm very unprepared. Let me just raise it for. Hey guys, welcome back. And now I've set up the tripod. You know. Whenever the tripod is fully extended, the legs take up so much room and everything, but, yeah, so. Now, I got the RAM here, now I'm gonna open it up. Come on. Whoa. Look at that. Yeah, look at that. He's not as tall. He's spreaders or whatever. Yeah. Let's do this. So I have to line it up with the socket here. So, it's gonna go this way. So, this is 1866 spares, and you saw in the introduction or whatever. So, I already looked at my motherboard manual to see which slots it goes into. And pressure on both sides. This is giving me a hard time. I already figured out how what to do with the dual channel mode. So,
That should be good. It also has aluminum heat spreaders here. It's nice. But if you're building a PC, it's probably the colored thing, so I always refer to your manual. Alright, let's do it until it clicks. There. So that is the memory installed. I can't speak French, I speak Spanish. Hola, me llamo Javier, ¿cómo estás? Okay, so now I'm gonna just grab the CPU cooler bracket and then thermal compound. So I'm gonna have to adjust the camera. Currently, the camera set up taller than me because I'm. Yeah. So I already did a dry fit and everything. First, I'm gonna set up this bracket here. I'm just gonna slide it through to get it lined up with these things. And let me just do this off camera. Behind the scenes that you'll never know more! So this is the thermal compound paste. It spreads heat better than air. So I'm gonna mess this up. I'll have to do it in the morning. So I have some more, but not here at home. So this came with my CPU cooler. So I have to put the size of a cooked grain of rice, that's what they say. I don't think so. So I put something bigger than that. Here. A little bit bigger, because more can't hurt. All can hurt is just trying to clean it off in the end, which isn't that great, but. But eh. I don't know if my back's getting it. Wait. I almost put the CPU cooler on before taking off the sticker that says warning, peel off before putting on. That would have been funny. No, it wouldn't. It would be sad.
Oh. Unless you want to stare at my back while I install the CPU cooler. I didn't, so I cut it. Now back to real time. Yay!
I'm tired and stuff. I haven't installed the graphics card yet. But I'm gonna power it on just to see if it works. So I'm gonna go here, wait, I need to zoom out and stuff. So I have this power cord here or cable, whatever you want. So I'm just gonna plug it into the back of my power supply. Turn on the power. So in the fan spin, I know that's gonna be working. I don't want to show any video or whatever. Can't. So then if I plug it in, I turn it on. Oh wait, no, turn it off, turn it off, turn it off. Turn off. Good. I've got to plug in the fan. Or the CPU fan.
That would have been disastrous. I forgot because I'm an idiot. Idiocracy. I never saw that movie, but I saw it on Netflix. I'm gonna work out the QO magazine for a minute. Let's see if this works. Oh, I have to turn on the power supply again. Hey, all the fans are spinning and everything. So, even though I don't have graphics cards and stuff, I would say that this works. Hey. So. That's a... It's not that loud, but... Yeah. Now, I will see you install the graphics card tomorrow morning. Good night. Hey, I don't want to zoom in.
Hello! Welcome back.
Where? As you probably saw in the beginning of the video, and Micro Center, again, they're out of stock of the GTX 962GB graphics card, so I have an even better graphics card, the GTX 420. So this was one taken out of an old Dell Inspire one, not the one that I have, another one. This would have been fine with my... Well, on my computer. Well, it doesn't need an external power, so I need to run another PCI. So all I have to do really is first, zoom in. Second, unscrew them. I think this one, I can always unscrew another one from under, but with the thumb screws. Let's screw this PCIe bracket. And I don't know how to unlock it. Okay. That's the tiny graphics card. The actual build, it's gonna be more this long and more back. Yeah, you understand. So now I'm gonna put the thumb screw back in. That it's not going anywhere or vibrating out. Okay, so now this will be fine for like a week or while I install Windows or whatever. So now, I'm gonna clear off my desk and take some really cool shots of it. Guys, I got my monitor next to me on my workbench plus the computers here. Yeah, but since I have to see where the monitor is, I'm just gonna put it here. So I'm gonna turn on the PC and see what it says. Yeah, so what this means is that we just have to restart it here. Press reset. And there we go. I know. And this thing isn't the most silent thing in the world, I gotta tell you that. Well, I know that first I have to put... I also have to put... Oh, wait, no, I have to put some stuff in the BIOS. So, I'm gonna go figure this out. I'm usually pressing the escape key because the BIOS. Just gonna. I think that said X there. I couldn't see it for long though. I'm pretty confused here. Nope. I'm gonna go get some help. I'll be back.
So, I forgot about the number F2 instead of escape. So, I set my boot drive to the Blu-ray disc when I installed Windows 10. But now, I'm gonna do stuff like fast boot. Ultra fast, of course. Put some all. CPU can overclock mode. Auto. I'm just gonna be setting this up again. Dual channel memory mode, yes. Aging 66 minutes. It looks like everything is working and everything, so I'm gonna go get my copy of Windows 10 here, blocking the product ID, because I don't want you to know that. Even though I'll be saying Windows are completely here. Okay. Okay, so now I'm going to So I already set the boot device to the Blu-ray drive for now. So I'm going to go press exit, save changes, and exit. Now it's going to reboot. It's going to be booting into the Blu-ray drive. A copyright. That's just gonna happen for the first boot. And hey, that looks like when I started up my old machine. Which is a couple feet away. Out with my arms. Come on. And also, by the way, I have a keyboard now set up down here. Normally, my setup is over to my right, but that's like a complete train wreck now. And it's messy. So I just use this clean area. What's happening? Hello? It says the green light. I'm gonna go wait a little bit. Wait, I'm on the road. I see stuff going by. When I'm on the road, I got a bug in my eye. When I'm on the road, not so clear as it is. Pressing the reset button. Now I'm gonna turn. Okay. So press the reset button. That's gonna do the BIOS thing.
What? I already selected a boot device.
Press this a bunch of times to make sure that it loads into the BIOS.
Hello? What's happening? I'm gonna... again. Boot. Boot option... one. Why no, it's not... Why isn't it recognized? That's on the Seagate drive. I'm gonna turn the system off and then, the connection is good for the Blu-ray drive. It's just weird how I didn't recognize it. And it says there that the green thing. That means it should be booting to that. Maybe F11? I may have pressed that too late. Where's this boot now? Oh, there it is. I can hear the disc spinning and the lights going. So this time I'm just gonna let it run and then I'm gonna... Hey guys, it just made a Windows loading sign and then it went to this page immediately. Like, no transition. Bleh. Okay, well, I guess I never installed Windows yet. Okay, so, this all makes sense down here to my US, because I bought in the US, of course. I'm not repair my computer. Install now. And soon it'll ask me to install. Is there a thought you should choose? Follow the steps. Okay, so now, for the product key, I'm just gonna turn this off. Okay, so I did my product key. This is blah blah blah, Microsoft license terms. I'm gonna not read this. So, custom upgrade. Well, I don't know anything on this drive. Yeah. It is an expansion drive. It was that. It says expansion drive because, I took it out of a Seagate portable drive, but it was just the normal drive inside, so it's just, it's called that. So, next. I know it's gonna do this, it'll be about 20 minutes. So I will see you in a tiny bitch. Bye. So much editing for me to do. Hey, what's up? It said starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, or whatever. It's doing that right now, so, it said that it's finishing up or whatever, so I decided to start recording again here. Yay! Wait, I'm zooming into it too much. So, I'm surprised I did this. I managed to do this, and also I think it's done. But I also need to install the drivers now. This is going to be fun. Come on. And also, by the way, guys, if you don't know the reason why the computer works in the first place, like boots up and whatever, even without drivers, because there's basic drivers on the motherboard. And standard stuff like keyboard and mice or whatever, that, but then getting devices ready, 36% or whatever, so. Oh, wait. Getting ready. Come on. I really need one of those cool slider things. I can do a cool pan effect. Still getting ready. Don't comment if you're if I post it to you. Don't comment just like blah, 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 if because I have Motorola and Android. And also that I like Legend of Zelda. I'm gonna turn on the LED lighty things. Oh wait, there's no more ports on my extension cable. I'm gonna have to go all the way under my desk to plug it into the strip outlet. Why does the world have to be hard? Yeah, LED lights are on. You probably faintly see that. Now, Windows is restarted again. I'm gonna play a virtual ocarina now, cause I want to. I'm genius at everything. Oh no, my volume on. Okay, each express settings, because it's easier. Okay, those were my arms. They crack whenever I lift them. Just a moment. I'm a genius. I'm totally playing this. Thank you.
Then. Again, yes, the moment. Hello. Okay, thanks. Background music. Oh, I can't feel my face when I'm with you. Sorry, it's on the top charts for a reason. This is getting boring. Come on. That wasn't part of the song, I just... Huh, you recently watched Beta 64. Don't miss this video. I think I just did it. It works, not... sort of. Display settings. Everything doesn't work... properly now. I have to go in the... Oh wait, no. I can't use the web yet. Because I need to bring the Cat 5e cable over. Has it reached that far? I know it has before with my Raspberry Pi. No. Wait a minute while I'm experiencing technical difficulties. There we go. Yeah. There. Now it reaches. There. Alright, let me see. Yes. Because I am at home. Yeah. I'm Cortana, blah, blah, blah. I'll do that later. I'm just going to go search the web address. First thing is the graphics driver, so... NVIDIA. Bro, what? The support? You know, wait, I didn't know I could connect to the internet.
Yeah, that was a driver though. Oh yeah. First thing I should probably do is, yeah, I was gonna say that this could, that I was gonna use this, but it's kind of, it could be outdated or whatever. So, download drivers, GeForce, hard drivers, scanning system. You know, my line is all these drivers. I'll be back to you in a second. Hey guys, so I installed the drivers or whatever. And right now I'm doing some updates and I pulled the task manager up because I could. And also I'm installing some of my other previous apps from before. So, as you can see here, it's working fine. By the way, that's not the CPU, that's the disk. It's actually very nice. Because if I was doing the same tasks on my other computer, it would take more, it would be more like at least 50% or whatever. The stuff I'm doing now, I'm installing Windows updates and I'm installing other things at the same time. My network's 54%, of course. And why won't it let me zoom fast when I'm recording a video? So yeah. So I'm pretty much done except for the time. It's the right date, but it's the wrong time. It's like 5:30. Wait, 5:30? That means, wait. I don't know if that makes sense. It's been about an hour since I put the graphics card. Okay, so, next time I see you, will be finishing stuff and benchmarks.